fishing, gone fishing.
The person who's gone fishing this afternoon is none other than Patricia Diamond. She's gone off deep sea fishing with Jonathan Croft and indeed Bertie, who's the skipper of the boat that leaves there from Bangor every day throughout the summer. But she started off by speaking to the proprietor of the boat, and his name is Brian Mahorg.
It's not any serious fishing at all. It's just if somebody wants to come down, they have a 6-year-old niece or a 10-year-old nephew. They arrive over from England and they say, what are we going to do with this youngster? And they usually end up in my boat at some time of their holiday.
So you have plenty of visitors from all over?
All over the world. People come from all ages and say, is that the White Heather used to be in such and such? Because it's quite an old boat itself.
Yes, tell me a bit about the White Heather.
The White Heather is the oldest licensed passenger boat in Ireland. And it was built 65 years ago in Bangor. And it's probably carried, at a guess, between 500,000 and 1 million passengers.
Where did it run from and to?
Well, it started off in Bangor. It went to Loch Ney, and in the 30s again it came back to Bangor. And then during the war, the Admiralty owned it. After the war, it went to Donaghadee, and in 1971, it was brought back to its home port again.
Old, knowledgeable fishermen, would they recognise the particular boat we're talking about?
Oh, yes. People from all over come and they recognise the name. It's changed shape. There's a wheelhouse on it. Years ago, there wouldn't have been a wheelhouse.
Woke up this morning, wanting to cry. Then I remembered, yes, I knew why. He's real good for having his cake. I'm gonna go fishing or jump in the lake. Yes, I'm gonna go fishing.
You're a member of the crew?
Yes.
Have you been interested in fishing all your life?
Yes, I love fishing.
What type of fish would you catch around here?
Mackerel, blocking, whiting, that's about all, you know.
And what do you do with the fish once you catch them?
Well, you can either eat them or throw them back or use them as bait. But if you catch wee tiddlers, you just throw them back.
Because they're not worth taking home to cook up, are they?
Well, you throw them back, so you wait till they're bigger and then get a feed out of them.
Johnny, you were saying that if the wind's blowing in, that means that the fish might be more inland, is that right?
Yes, well, see, they come with the wind sometimes. It all depends.
Okay, I've got the reel here and Johnny's given me a lesson. What weight would the reel be?
Well, they all come in different weights.
So with this particular reel, like, I could catch some mackerel?
Well, it all depends. See, usually on the hooks, sometimes they glow up and sometimes just attract the fish.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, what if there was a wee shark here on by? Do you think I'd be able to pick it up with this one?
No, not really, because you need kind of a bigger hook and more bait.
And what bait are you using?
Well, I'm not using bait. See, hooks just attract them, so they go for that. But you can use bait if you want, you know.
And clicking in the reel just to see. It's quite a few pounds, this particular fishing rod. And I can see my reel coming out, and there's the weight at the end of it. So I've never been fishing before. Oh, it seems all very complicated. Is it very complicated, very technical?
Well, no, it's very easy, in fact. You just let it come down a bit faster than that, you know, and then the fish will just bite it. You know, or you can just go down halfway and jig up and down. It's only a matter of letting down and jigging up and down. There's no technique or anything to it.
We thought that we had a catch, but some of the lines got tangled. Does that happen very often?
Well, if there's a lot of people in the boat, it would, but if there's, you know, very few in the boat, it would be far better because there's less tangles and stuff.
Sweet talking liar!
Yes, I think we're going over here, we're getting the fish. Oh boy, what's this here?
It's mackerel.
Here's another one coming.
They're right on the bottom.
Another mackerel? Well done.
Right, well, this is your rod, so I give you honour for taking it off.
Oh, good. Johnny, you didn't prepare me for this. Hold on, we'll see.
Oh, gosh, I don't know.
Okay, you hold it there. Okay.
Does this hurt the fish?
No. Okay.
And what have you done? You've just taken it out. Now, relieve the fish. And what happens now?
Well, do you want the
Could it live? Maybe, do you think, or would it?
Do you want to, do you want it?
Oh, gosh, what are you going to do? Oh! And that's it. Is there any cruelty involved there?
No.
That was quick and painless.
Yep, that's the way to cut.
But now it's still shaking. What does that mean?
That's the nerves, just, you know.
But the fish is dead, definitely dead.
It's just nerves now, you know.
And there was no cruelty involved, because that's the first time I've ever had a fish. Is that a good sized fish there?
It's average. Well, I caught a bigger one last night, so I did. And the biggest mackerel being caught was over there at a buoy near Wilson's Point, and it was 2.5 pounds. And it was a very big mackerel. That's the biggest fish that has been caught in the Belfast Lock.
Yeah. Oh. What weight would be that particular fish?
Maybe 0.5 pound.
Okay, but I tell you what, Johnny, if my rod picks up another fish, can we put it back into the water again?
Yes, that's fine, yep.
Right, I've got a fish. Hold on a minute, I'm going to reel up. Hold on.
Right.
But it's going into the boat. I'll turn over the other way, right?
There we go. Just go as quickly as I can and reel it up.
Yep.
Right, okay.
No, yes, a couple. Three.
Step back. You're taking some more of these poor wee things off. Oh, Bertie, I don't know if I'll ever be able to look a wee fish in the eye again.
Do you eat fish?
It's my favourite food.
Yes, there you are. Well, now somebody catches them.
We decided we could use a little something to eat, so we went to a house on Rampart Street. We knocked on the door and it opened with ease, and the lush little miss said, "Come in, please." And before we could even bat an eye, we were right in the middle of a big fish fry. It was Friday.
Gillespie, you're also a member of the crew. Which crew person like you do?
Well, it's just basically arranging the tackle and rods for the people out on the trips, collecting them again, and helping tie up. It's not such a bad job.
How often do you go out on the boats?
Well, if it's a full week, then it'll be 3 times a day, 7 days. 2.5 hours per trip. Getting you loud and clear, Paul, over.
Are you getting the fish all right where you are? Over.
Well, we're just redoing the drift here. We aren't bringing in them yet, the odd mackerel. Should be heading in them any minute now, over.
Ask Bertie if 3 dozen mackerels is up for a spread there. I just caught 3 dozen myself there.
Well, 6 was enough for him, so I'm sure that'll do. Right, over.
Very well, I'll throw in the drum tea.
Okay. Right, over there.
Woke up this morning, wanting to cry. Then I remembered, yes, I knew why. He's real good for having his tea. I'm gonna go fishing or jump in the lake. Yes, I'm gonna go fishing.
Brian, I didn't really, really get into the idea of fishing. This is the first time I've been fishing, and I'm afraid with all that blood and that guts and taking the things out, the insides out of fish, it didn't really appeal to me. But what is the appeal?
The appeal, I don't know. People seem to enjoy it, and it's something that most people were brought up to, and they just continue it. My boat seems to be the boat where they all start their fishing careers on, and then as time goes on, if they take fishing up seriously, they go elsewhere to the Causeway Coast. And if they don't take it too serious and they like to have an enjoyable afternoon's out, and sometimes we don't catch fish, but don't be letting on, we come down aboard me. We supply everything. All you need to do is bring warm clothes. I would say one of the biggest problems is people arrive down in a t-shirt. That would be the main problem, and they say, oh, this is great. And within 5 minutes, you're frozen. So if you are coming down, it's best to bring good warm clothes. That's the main thing. I have everything else.
What about fishing yourself? I mean, do you ever get fed up looking at the fish?
There was a man died a few years ago called Jimmy Scott, and he used to say, if you have an enemy, buy him a boat.
Here in the water, look at him shine. There goes a big one, that one is mine. Cast off the reel now, I got the feel now. Snap the pan fly rod, I'll catch me a trout. Yes, sweet talking liar, you're in for a fall. You tell me a story, talk to the wall. Gonna go my way on down the highway. I'm gonna go fishing and catch me a trout.
What pleasure to get from fishing? I like it, then I'll go home. It's a good pastime.
I'm gonna go fishing and catch me a trout.
Ladies and gentlemen, Patricia Diamond, fish killer. I can't say that, actually, but she asked them to throw them back. But she still eats them if somebody else will catch them for her.